exoplanets. Most exoplanets have been discovered in our galaxy, the Milky Way. According to NASA's Kepler Space Telescope, there are more planets in the universe than stars. As we measure exoplanets' sizes, diameters, and masses, we can tell how rocky they are, like Earth and Venus, and how gas-rich they are, like Jupiter and Saturn. Exoplanets are elements similar to those on our solar system's planets, but their mixes may differ. Water or ice may dominate some planets, while iron or carbon may dominate others. There are Earth-sized lava worlds encased in molten seas, puffy planets, dense cores of planets still orbiting their stars, and worlds with molten seas. Exoplanets are rare for astronomers to see through their telescopes, much like you might see Saturn through a telescope from Earth. Direct imaging is used to find exoplanets, typically young gas giants orbiting very far from their stars. Thousands of exoplanets have been seen since the 1990s, and we've detected them with various methods since then. Exoplanets are now part of our universe. There are thousands of confirmed planets. This is only a tiny part of the entire galaxy. As we increase the number and observing power of robotic telescopes deployed in space, the number could rise into the tens of thousands within a decade. Thousands of worlds have been discovered using space telescopes by observing transits, the slight dimming of light from a star when its tiny planet passes in front of our telescopes. There are two fundamental techniques for finding exoplanets: measuring the dimming of a star passing in front of a world, called the transit method, or monitoring the spectrum of a star for a subtle Doppler shift caused by the planet pulling on it. Another method for detecting neutron stars is gravitational lensing, or the wobble method. However, using multiple methods, we can learn the vital statistics of whole planet systems without directly imaging them. Seven roughly Earth-sized planets orbiting a small red star in the TRAPPIST-1 system, about 40 light-years away. Both ground and space telescopes have been used to study TRAPPIST-1. Observations from space revealed their diameters and the subtle gravitational influence these seven closely packed planets have on each other, and scientists determined their mass. The seven planets of this system are the most well-known outside of our own, though much remains unknown about them, such as whether they have atmospheres, oceans, or ice sheets. Now that we know their mass and diameter, we can build a model for them. Furthermore, scientists can estimate the temperature of these planets from the amount of energy radiated by their stars. Even if you were standing on one, we could make reasonable estimates of the light level and the color of the sky. Exoplanets orbit other stars. As of now, scientists have classified exoplanets into four categories: gas giant, Neptunian, super-Earth, and terrestrial. There are many types of planets beyond our solar system, ranging from gas giants larger than Jupiter to minor rocky planets about the size of Earth or Mars. They can be hot enough to boil metal or deep frozen to prevent it from melting. In their orbits, a year lasts only a few days. They can orbit two suns simultaneously. A few exoplanets wander through the galaxy like sunless rogues in permanent darkness. As we explore the variety of planets among the stars, it's helpful to compare their characteristics with those of our own worlds. Describe the different exoplanets, planets outside our solar system, in terms of hot Jupiters, warm Neptunes, and super-Earths. Planets and stars in a galaxy. Our Milky Way galaxy is a thick stream of stars on the darkest, clearest nights. Its spiraling expanse contains over 100 billion stars, including the Sun. We are already approaching trillions of planets in the galaxy if each star has not just one, but a system of Earths like ours. Despite speculating about such possibilities for thousands of years, our generation is the first to know with certainty that there are exoplanets. Far away, in fact. Proxima Centauri, our nearest neighbor, is home to at least one planet, likely a rocky one. 4 light-years away, over 40 trillion kilometers, 25 trillion miles. Most exoplanets discovered so far are hundreds or thousands of light-years away. There's no way to get to them, and we won't be leaving footprints soon. In the good news, we can observe them, take their temperatures, smell their atmospheres, and perhaps one day, detect signs of life in the pixels of light that are captured from these dim, distant worlds. Discoveries of exoplanets and mysteries. 51 Pegasi b, a hot Jupiter orbiting a sun-like star 50 light-years away, exploded onto the world stage as the first exoplanet discovered in the early 1990s. The landmark discovery came in 1995. Since then, thousands of new species have been found. Planet types are determined by their size and mass. Within each size-mass classification, there are variations. Researchers have also noted a strange gap in planet sizes. It's named after Benjamin Fulton, the lead author of a paper describing it. Kepler data show that planets between 1.5 and 2 times Earth's size diameter are rare. That puts them among the super-Earths. This is a critical size in planet formation. Planets that reach this size rapidly attract thick atmospheres of hydrogen and helium gas and balloon up into gaseous planets, while planets less massive than this can't support heavy atmospheres and remain mainly rocky terrestrial bodies. The more minor planets that orbit close to their stars may have been stripped of their atmospheres and are Neptune-like worlds. Each planet type has a different interior and exterior appearance based on its composition. Planets that are gas giants are as big as Saturn or Jupiter, the largest worlds in our solar system, or even more prominent. Within these broad categories, there is more variety. One of the first planets found is a hot Jupiter, a gas giant that orbits so close to its star that its temperature rises by thousands of degrees, Fahrenheit or Celsius. Neptune and Uranus are similar in size to Neptune in our solar system. Each will have a different composition inside, but hydrogen and helium dominate their outer atmospheres and rocky cores. In addition, we're discovering mini Neptunes, more minor planets than Neptune, but more significant than Earth. Such worlds do not exist in our solar system. Super-Earths are terrestrial planets that may or may not have atmospheres. Their masses are more significant than Earth's, but their weight is more minor than Neptune's. Planets on Earth are more minor and composed of rock, silicate, water, and carbon. We will examine whether some of them have atmospheres, oceans, or other signs of habitability in the future. How do gas giants work? Helium and/or hydrogen make up most of the mass of a gas giant. This planet has gas swirling around a solid core, similar to Jupiter and Saturn, in our solar system. Exoplanets with gas giants can be more significant than Jupiter and closer to their stars than any planet in our solar system. Our understanding of planet formation and evolution was based on the 8 or 9 planets in our solar system for most of human history. Since the discovery of over 4,000 exoplanets over the last 25 years, all that has changed. In our solar system, gas giants such as Jupiter and Saturn are composed primarily of helium and/or hydrogen. These broad categories conceal a great deal of diversity. Often referred to as hot Jupiters, gas giants near their stars experience so much heat that their temperatures swell to thousands of degrees, Fahrenheit or Celsius. Hot Jupiters, for instance, were among the first exoplanet types to be discovered. The tight orbits of these giant planets cause their stars to wobble, causing a significant shift in their spectrum of light. Using the radial velocity method, it was easier to detect hot Jupiters back in the early days of planet hunting. Exoplanet Kelt-9b. A world as hot as some stars. Even molecules cannot survive the extreme heat of Kelt-9b. Hydrogen molecules are likely torn apart on the dayside of the tidally locked planet Kelt-9b, unable to reassemble until their disjointed atoms flow around to the planet's night side. Kelt-9b has a surface temperature of over 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit, 4,600 Kelvin, making it hotter than many stars. A Blua-type star, Kelt-9, is even hotter and likely unraveling the world through evaporation. Kelt-9b is 2.8 times more massive than Jupiter in mass and density, but only half as dense. Despite the extreme radiation from its star, the planet's atmosphere has inflated like a balloon because of the powerful radiation. Besides orbiting perpendicularly to the star, the planet also spins perpendicularly to its spin axis. Our solar system's plane would be analogous to a planet orbiting perpendicular to it. On this planet, a year lasts only 2 days. Kelt-9 is more than twice the size and nearly twice the heat of our sun. In star time, Kelt-9 is only 300 million years old. The planet's atmosphere may be constantly bombarded by ultraviolet radiation, resulting in a tail of evaporated planetary material like that of a comet. Kelt-9b. Exoplanet Kepler-7b star system. The giant planet in the solar system is composed mainly of gas. Juno entered Jupiter's orbit on July 4, 2016, to study our solar system's king. Jupiter has no comparison to some of the exotic exo-Jupiters in our galaxy, which may number in the billions. Kepler-7b is over 3,000 light-years away, a gas giant 60% larger than Jupiter, but half the mass of Jupiter. Kepler-7b is roughly as dense as styrofoam. It orbits its massive star so closely in a scorching 5 days that it becomes tidally locked like the Moon. It is over 12 times hotter than Jupiter. By day, one side roasts while the other is permanently enveloped in darkness. Floating Kepler-7b would be possible if you had an enormous bathtub. With data from NASA's Kepler and Spitzer telescopes, Kepler-7b was also the first exoplanet to have its clouds mapped. According to its cloud map, superheated air can be conducted from the roasting front of the planet across endless freezing nights to warm the side. NASA's Juno mission could also explore our galaxy's giants and hot Jupiters. Gas-dominated planets of similar size to Jupiter orbit extremely close to their parent stars, circling them in as little as 18 hours. They are unlike any planets in our solar system, where the closest planets to the Sun are rocky and orbit much farther away. Is a hot Jupiter formed close to its star or farther away before migrating inward? What would it reveal about the history of the planets in our own solar system if these giants migrated? Kepler-7b. These questions can only be answered by observing many of these hot giants early in their formation. Our understanding of exoplanets may be expanded with the discovery of HIP-67522b, the newest hot Jupiter ever discovered, in June 2020. This hot Jupiter orbits a star that is about 17 million years old, so it is probably only a few million years younger than most known hot Jupiters. It takes about 7 days for the planet to orbit its star, which has a mass similar to our Sun. The diameter of HIP-67522b, which is only about 490 light-years from Earth, is about 10 times that of Earth. Based on its size, it is clearly a gas-dominated planet. It could lead to the discovery of younger hot Jupiters and a better understanding of how planets form throughout the universe. HIP-67522b. Massive migrations. There are three main hypotheses for how hot Jupiters get close to their parent stars. The first is that they form there and stay there. Besides the scorching heat, young stars frequently erupt with massive explosions and stellar winds, which could disperse emerging worlds. In such an intense environment, it's challenging to imagine planets forming. Gas giants are more likely to form farther from their parent star, past the snow line boundary, where cooler temperatures and solid materials can form. Planets like Jupiter are almost entirely composed of gas with solid cores. These cores would be easier to develop past the snow line, where frozen materials could cling together like a snowball. Assuming this is true, the other two hypotheses suggest hot Jupiters then migrate near their stars. When and why would this migration occur? One theory states that hot Jupiters begin their journey early in the planetary system's history, while the star and planet are still surrounded by the disk of gas and dust that formed them. Suppose the disk interacts with the mass of the Earth and causes the gas giant to migrate inward. Third, hot Jupiters may migrate toward their star when the gravitational pull of other planets around the star can drive their migration. This third hypothesis most likely doesn't apply in this case, since HIP-67522b is already so close to its star so soon after its formation. The debate about how Jupiters form can't be decided with one young, hot Jupiter. We are developing with the stars. Using NASA's Spitzer Space Telescope, astronomers discovered that gas giant planets form quickly within the first 10 million years of the life of a sun-like star. As gas giants form in the debris disk surrounding a young star, they could get their start from gas. A seed is formed by colliding asteroids and comets, and when its mass reaches a critical level, its gravitational pull rapidly pulls gas from the disk to create the planet. Spitzer and ground-based telescopes searched for gas around 15 different sun-like stars, most of which are 3 million to 30 million years old. Using Spitzer's infrared spectrometer instrument, they searched for relatively warm gas in the inner regions of these star systems, a part comparable to that between Earth and Jupiter in our own solar system. In addition, they used ground-based radio telescopes to search for cooler gas in the outer regions of these systems, an area comparable to the zone around Saturn and beyond. Several million-year-old stars in the study have less than 10% of Jupiter's mass in the gas surrounding them. Jupiter and Saturn are giant gas planets, so they either have already formed or won't form. Neptunian planets, what are they? Exoplanets like Neptune and Uranus in our solar system are similar in size to Neptune. The atmospheres of Neptunian planets are dominated by hydrogen and helium, with cores made of rock and heavier metals. Neptunian exoplanets are approximately the same size as Neptune or Uranus in our solar system. Several Neptunian exoplanets within our solar system, but all are rocky and have heavier metals at their core. Neptune is about 4 times Earth's size and radius, and almost 17 times its mass. Neptunian exoplanets may be mixed in their interiors. Hydrogen and helium dominate the atmospheres of Neptunian planets. In addition, we're discovering many Neptunes that are smaller than Neptune and more significant than Earth. Our solar system has no planets like these. Exoplanet HAT-P26b. A planet just like Neptune. Exoplanet HAT-P26b orbits a K-type star and is like Neptune. In 2010, it was discovered. A single orbit of its star takes it 4.2 days, and its distance from its star is 0.0479 astronomical units. HAT-P26b. Exoplanet GJ-436b. This hot world has a secret: it lacks methane. A Neptune-sized exoplanet orbiting an M-type star is GJ-436b. A single orbit of its star takes it 2.6 days, and it is 0.0291 astronomical units from its star. In 2004, it was discovered. A 33 light-year distance separates us from this unusual world. According to NASA's Spitzer Space Telescope, the hot planet orbiting a star beyond our sun lacks methane, an element common to many planets in our solar system. The typical mix of hydrogen, carbon, and oxygen in planetary atmospheres and temperatures up to 1,000 Kelvin, 1,340 degrees Fahrenheit, would cause significant methane and a small amount of carbon monoxide. Spitzer's observations showed the planet does not contain methane, even though it is about 800 Kelvin or 980 degrees Fahrenheit. The planet is too compact to be mainly made of hydrogen gas, like Jupiter, but is too far away to be a rocky super-Earth. Researchers think it is primarily composed of an exotic form of water, hardened by pressure rather than temperature. Besides hydrogen and helium, Uranus and Neptune contain water, ammonia, and methane. In the cold outer solar system, these three chemicals are often found frozen as ice, so Uranus and Neptune are often referred to as ice giants, even though their interiors are warm enough to melt their ices. 2014 saw the discovery of a 25,000 light-year away ice giant exoplanet. It orbits its star as Uranus does our sun, so we do not know its composition or what its atmosphere comprises. Compositions of distant planets can be difficult to determine. NASA's Hubble and Spitzer glean information about planet atmospheres by analyzing starlight. Light passing through a planet's atmosphere is absorbed by molecules and atoms at specific wavelengths, preventing the telescope from seeing it. More giant planets appear as more light is blocked. Scientists determine the molecules in the atmosphere by analyzing the amount of light blocked by the world at different wavelengths, called spectroscopy. The Transiting Exoplanet Survey satellite, TESS, detects planets smaller than Neptune that transit stars bright enough to allow follow-up spectroscopic observations of their atmospheres. In the atmospheres of Neptunian exoplanets, there are usually thick clouds that block light, obscuring the molecule's signatures. After its launch in 2021, the James Webb Space Telescope will observe the atmospheres of exoplanets more closely. GJ-436b In 2017, astronomers discovered clear skies on HAT-P11b, the Neptune-sized planet. The scientists could see water vapor molecules in the exoplanet's atmosphere without clouds blocking their view. HAT-P11b has a rocky core, like our Neptune, and is gaseous. Clouds may exist more profound in their atmosphere, but Hubble, Spitzer, and Kepler's observations showed that the upper region is cloud-free. Scientists could detect water vapor molecules in the atmosphere because of this good visibility. HAT-P11b. Hot Jupiter-sized planets and super-Earths have been discovered near their stars. There have been fewer hot Neptunes, whose atmospheres are hotter than 1,700 degrees Fahrenheit, over 900 degrees Celsius. It has only been possible to find a few hot Neptunes so far. Exoplanets like HAT-P11b are only warm because they orbit beyond the region where hot Neptunes are expected to be found. Considering the mysterious hot Neptune desert, either such alien worlds are rare, or they were plentiful once but were altered. Astronomers have discovered that one of the warmest Neptunes, GJ-436b, has lost its atmosphere in the past few years. Like an untethered hot air balloon, intense radiation from a star can heat an atmosphere far enough to escape the planet's gravitational pull. A giant cloud of fleeing gas encircles the planet and dissipates into space. Planets like that aren't expected to evaporate away, but hotter Neptunes might not be so lucky. This could be the case for the planet GJ-3470b, a hot Neptune that loses its atmosphere 100 times faster than GJ-436b does. Each world is about 3.7 million miles, 5.5 million kilometers, away from its star. Mercury, our innermost planet, is a tenth the distance from the Sun. Since GJ-3470b is not as dense as GJ-436b, it may evaporate faster because of its inability to gravitationally hang onto the heated atmosphere. Two planets are orbiting red dwarf stars, but GJ-3470b orbits a much younger star. It is only 2 billion years old, whereas GJ-3470b's star is between 4 and 8 billion years old. GJ-436b is bombarded with more blistering radiation by the younger star than GJ-436b is by GJ-436. GJ-3470b. Neptunes with hot and warm atmospheres could eventually shrink to mini-Neptunes, planets with hydrogen-dominated atmospheres larger than Earth but smaller than Neptune. Alternatively, they may shrink even further to become super-Earths, more massive rocky versions of our planet. The discovery of two evaporating warm Neptunes supports the theory that the hotter versions of these usually distant worlds may represent planets in transition. What lies beyond the snow line? Scientists used gravitational microlensing to discover planets. An analysis of planetary systems' icy outer realms revealed that Neptune mass worlds may be the most common type of planet. Scientists suspect planets can form most efficiently far from host stars, where scientists are most hopeful of finding planets. The study's lead scientist, Daisuke Suzuki, a former postdoctoral researcher at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, and the University of Maryland, Baltimore County, said the study found a sweet spot in the size of cold planets. "We conclude that planets with Neptune-like masses are about 10 times more common than planets with Jupiter-like masses," Suzuki said. Because of comparing planet frequency to the mass ratios between planets and stars and the distances between them, the scientists found that cold, Neptune mass worlds are most likely to occur beyond the so-called snow line, the space beyond which water stays frozen during planetary formation. The snow line was thought to be in the middle of the asteroid belt, about 2.7 times Earth's distance from the Sun. How does a super-Earth work? Unlike any other planets in our solar system, super-Earths are more massive than Earth yet lighter than ice giants like Neptune and Uranus. These planets are twice as giant as Earth and have a mass of between 10 and 100 times that of Earth. Depending on their composition, they can be made of either gas or rock. A super-Earth refers only to the size of an exoplanet, more significant than Earth and smaller than Neptune, but not to the similarities between them and Earth. Since these planets are unique to our solar system, their true nature remains unknown. However, they are found throughout our galaxy. Exoplanet GJ15AB. A neighboring planet with a lot of strange properties. A strange property abounds in this planetary system. GJ15AB, the innermost planet, takes just 11 days to circle the star, 1 year on this planet. The planet weighs 3 times more than Earth, making it a super-Earth with a surface temperature of 530 degrees Fahrenheit, 276 Celsius. It's also superheated, with an estimated surface temperature of 530 degrees Fahrenheit, 276 Celsius. GJ15AC, its sister world, is quite different. There are 36 times as many stars in its stellar family as Earth, and it appears to orbit its excellent and small parent star roughly every 20 years. Even though the temperature is unknown, it must be pretty cold in this distant, possibly icy orbit, comparable to Saturn's rotation around the Sun.
Yeah.